guys, this video is about fructose malabsorption and fruit intolerance. It's part one of a series. In this first video about fructose malabsorption, we're going to look into the two different tests that are used to diagnose fructose malabsorption, fructose intolerance. You're also going to discover why these tests are highly inaccurate, and we're going to talk about why so many people now are getting diagnosed with fructose malabsorption. There's something behind that, and I'd love to share that with you. My name is Peggy from peggyschirmer.com. I warmly welcome you to Gut Feelings, this channel to support you to become your own health expert so you have all the energy you need to manifest your dreams and share your gifts with the world. So guys, let's talk about fructose malabsorption, fructose intolerance, and this big fruit fear that we are being confronted with. So first of all, fruits are the most important food group to heal any issues that you have with your body and to prevent you from aging, prevent you from brain damage, and basically just allow you to live a happier and more healthy life. If I say that to people, a lot of people then come up and say, no, but I'm fructose intolerant, I can't digest fruits, I need to keep away from fruits. So, and then I ask them, what did you do? And then they say they did one of these two tests, either a breath test or an enzymatic test. And we're going to look into what these tests are, what to think about them, and how to see these results a bit more critically. So number one, the breath test. The breath test basically detects through your breath if there's any sugar that didn't get absorbed by your intestines. Now, here's the thing with this breath test, why it's inaccurate and why you shouldn't give too much on that. Because the most problem we have with fruits and sugar is not because of the fruits, it's because of the fat. Most of our diets are highly loaded with fat, we eat way too much fat, and as fat is the food component that takes the longest to be absorbed by our body, needs the most energy, the most enzymes from our liver, it also puts a lot of stress on our digestive system, especially if we eat a high fat diet. Now, whenever fat is present in your digestive tract, and you put sugar on top, the sugar can't be absorbed. It clogs your intestinal lining and your blood vessels, and then the sugar can't really get into the bloodstream because the fat is blocking it. For example, if you ate dairy, dairy is high in lactose, which is basically a sugar. Yeah, people don't know that, they think they just eat fat. No, they eat sugar and fat. If you eat sugar and fat combined, there comes the problem. Why you can't absorb the sugar, the fructose. So dairy is a big problem. Also, even with this test, you imagine you eat a chocolate bar 5 days prior to this test, which is high in fat and high in sugar, you're going to get a positive test result because the sugar is still present there. The breath test, see that, highly critical. Don't just believe everything. It's likely going to be inaccurate. And the second one, I can't absorb fruit. What did they do? They did the enzymatic test. This fructose malabsorption test, fructose intolerance test, tests for a specific enzyme that your liver needs to produce in order to absorb fructose. It's called aldolase B, and basically what doctors are presuming is that when they can't find this enzyme, you can't absorb fructose. And there is a percentage of truth to that. This enzyme really helps with fructose absorption, but here we come again with the high fat diet. This enzyme is just one out of hundreds of enzymes that are likely to be diminished in your liver. And this is because if the liver is clogged, if this large organ here in your upper right part of the body is highly under stress because you eat too much fat, because it needs to produce a lot of bile, needs to produce a lot of digestive enzymes, it's going to be exhausted at some point. And then you don't eat enough fruit, which helps the liver heal, which fuels the liver, then you get problems. So you have this enzyme, you have this aldolase B. It's not a problem that you inherited from generations before you, that you can't produce this enzyme, it's just diminished. And your body, as soon as you start to reduce the fat in your diet, really highly reduce that, avoid dairy products, avoid eggs, and on the same time go for healing fruits, ripe fruits, eat them alone, eat them as mono meals, don't combine them with anything, especially not with fat. You're gonna help your liver heal, you're gonna produce more enzymes, and you're also gonna amp up the production of aldolase B so you can absorb fructose more easily. Now guys, in the second part of the series, in the next video, we're gonna talk about a bit more about fruits and what you need to know if you eat fruits and you still feel discomfort. Don't think it's about fructose malabsorption, because it's very likely not the case. I'm going to share with you how you can get out of this vicious cycle. I'm gonna link you the second part of the video right now here. For now, I'd love to conclude this video with an encouragement to think critically about what the medical industry tells you. Yeah, all these tests that are supported by medical industry, and if you think that medical industry has your best interest in mind, don't forget that it's an industry. Doctors, they're doing their best, but they are also highly influenced by all the funded research that goes into producing new supplements, new medications to help people with fructose intolerance, for example. Well, the thing is, why the medical industry is so interested in all this kind of fructose intolerance is because some of these people who are behind the scenes know that fruit is highly healing. They know that it contains antioxidants, vitamin C, and when you stop eating that, you get more problems and then you buy more supplements. Also, out of fresh fruit, you can't really make a lot of money, but you can make money if people are fructose intolerant and then they need additional vitamins, they need special supplements. That's why there's more research into fructose intolerance than, for example, in the healing benefits of a banana, which kills off SIBO, which heals your liver, which lowers blood sugar levels. So just a recommendation from the bottom of my heart to develop a more critical view on what you get told by all these fear and panic making of fruit and diet, and really connect back to the instincts of your body. Because your body, if you see a tomato, for example, red and glowing, you're gonna have an intuitive response. You're gonna want to eat that. And that's a response from your body that you can learn to trust again. And that's what I wish for you. I see you in the next video. Have a great day. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.